The Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources is calling on community members and traditional authorities to take drastic measures in resisting the operations of illegal miners in their respective jurisdictions. Now, applauding inhabitants of Sabronum for strongly opposing the activities of illegal miners in their community, the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources wants other communities to emulate that, stressing that government alone cannot stop the menace. Our Middle Belt Bureau Chief Edward Opon-Mafo has more in this report.
Deploying various strategies since 2017, government has been struggling to clamp down on illegal mining, popularly known as galamsey. The worsening effects of illegal mining is evident in polluted states of various water bodies and destruction of forest reserves. Inhabitants of Sabronum in the Ashanti region recently opposed the activities of a group they believe was about to engage in illegal mining in the area as they set ablaze a truck allegedly carrying an excavator to a forest reserve in the area. Deputy Lands and Natural Resources Minister Benito Usubio has commended the residents for their vigilance. He also asked other communities to do same to help curtail the illegal mining in the country. According to Benito Usubio, community members play a crucial role in the fight against illegal mining. He further indicated that government needs strong resistance from the public in order to help address the canker.
As for galamsey, I will keep on saying it. All of us have to get involved to address the issue of galamsey. Because as we are here now, there's somebody somewhere in Wasa digging. We are here. So if we leave it alone for only government to fight it, then it will be difficult for us to be able to ensure that we are fighting it to the fullest maximum potential. We need the citizenry, our chiefs, government officials, security officials, everybody, including citizens, the local people. What if the local people say they will not let you mine illegally in their area? There's no way you can do it.
The Chief Executive Officer of Forestry Commission, John Alote, disclosed that its partnership with Star Agro Limited is helping to reclaim various degraded areas as more trees are being planted.
They have a laboratory that can generate 100,000 seedlings per month. They can ramp it up to about 500,000 a month within 6 months. Additionally, the lab that we have here, we have some Indians here, but within the next 3 months, we are going to have 80% of the people who are going to work here as Ghanaians. Going to work here, 80% of the staff they are going to have here will be Ghanaians, and that is significant. They are also going to work on both the indigenous species and the exotic species.
For the managing director of Star Agroforestry Limited, he's stressing on the need to use technology to plant more trees to restore the country's ecology.
This facility is to bring Ghana on the world map in the agriculture, where we are lacking. At present, the first class and the developed countries are using the latest technologies, and their production and everything per acreage is very high. They got the best of the product, they get the best of the yield. So they are also, they self-consume, after self-consumption of the country, they also do the export, which brings them the revenue. Ghana was licking this facility for the long time. It's been 20 years, so last 5 and 6 years, we were looking that Ghana forestry and everything is not able to grow that way that it should be. We have the land, we have the water, we have the rain, everything we have. Only the technology was lacking. So with that forestry commission, because we are regular with the forestry commission, we used to discuss a lot with them. Why we are not ahead of the other countries, and or why we are not able to be par with them. So that was the technology. So we have studied, then we have found that the best way to do this thing is the tissue culture lab.